naked beer drinking rock and rollers. It's time for Roller Games! Direct from the world famous Super Rollerdome, it's Roller Games! Tonight, America's team, the team on that trail against the bad boys of bad attitude. Will the Icebox chill out the Monster Man with his big deep freeze play? Will Skinny Minnie pull her weight on the wall of death? And can Georgia Haas feed the T-Bird Twins to the Gators? Plus, you wanted them back, and we got them. Warrant returns to the Super Rollerdome stage with two big hits. All tonight on
David Sands, this is Chuck Underwood from the Super Rollerdome, which tonight is going to be showcasing a classic matchup of good versus evil, the Los Angeles T-Birds against bad attitude.
Chuck, you know, the motivating force for any team that has been robbed is, of course, revenge. And after last week, the T-Birds were absolutely robbed in the last seconds of the game by the Violators when their manager, Skaw, came out and just nailed the T-Bird Gator Skater with his bullwhip. They're seen in our isolated camera. And I'll tell you, this week, I think these T-Birds are out for revenge. But, Chuck, look who they have to face.
Bad attitude. The skaters with the perfect record. None of them has ever made midnight curfew. Their manager is the tart and toxic Georgia Haas. And their number one torpedo is Monster Man Bernie Jackson, the bully of the roller game schoolyard.
He definitely is. Last week, he was humiliated by the Icebox when the Icebox used that big deep freeze play in the last seconds of the big semifinal. And he humiliated the Monster Man in front of a worldwide audience. And this woman right here was humiliated as well. There she is, the skunk, Georgia Haas. Her antics stink so much that her smell brings tears to my eyes, Chuck.
Well, after only 7 days, they get a chance to avenge that defeat. Let's go downstairs to Shelley.
Tonight's match may get bloody. I was back in the locker room earlier, and Bad Attitude's Monster Man was pounding his head against the wall. I guess that's how this nut gets prepped for the game. Meanwhile, their coach, Georgia Haas, says she has a bombshell to drop that could be devastating to the Thunderbirds. What does this gray-haired grandmotherly she-devil have in mind? We'll find out. But first, let's meet the Thunderbirds!
World champions in 19 of their 30 years of existence.
Here they are, America's team. The sky's the limit for this team right here, led by the legendary Ralphie Valadares. He has just been nominated to go into the Roller Sports Hall of Fame. And Chuck, he is well deserving of that title.
He has been skating in this sport since 1951. Signed a professional contract at age 17 when he came up from Guatemala. He is adored the world over and has taken this team and this sport to shores in every corner of the globe. Now, their game tonight, David, is going to match up the two largest animals in the league. And you're going to be watching them especially closely tonight.
Absolutely. They're right here. The Monster Man of Bad Attitude at 220 pounds takes on the Icebox. The big Icebox of the T-Birds. There he is right there. The man known for the deep freeze. As we see it, this was the replay from last week when the Icebox just nailed Monster Man in the final seconds of that big game.
Well, now for the rules of the sport. Four skaters from each team will skate at one time. The only ones who can score are the jetters for each. They are the ones who will be wearing the helmet, and they line up in this first lap behind the jetpack as the block is ahead of them are called. And the initial jetters will be a pair of pocket-sized peewees in the red, white, and blue Dynamite. Daryl Davis, only 146 pounds, and that man, 120-pound bull ball, Scott Pasto. They both get above only that bottom line on the wall of death, and each gets 2 points. Over the jump, likewise, 2 points as they keep their balance. Now comes the jockeying for individual points as the bulldog heads for row three. Dynamite will now try to pass as many black jerseys as he can, but rear blocker Monster Man will try to prevent it. Can he get around him? He goes outside and cuts inside, and yes, there's a single point. And another as Charlie Saunders misses, and Dr. Fu misses. And Dynamite is racking up good points for his T-Bird in this opening 45-second scoring cycle. Charlie Saunders misses with a flying hip block, and the cycle ends with the T-Birds leading 8-4. Nicely done by Dynamite.
Oh! Oh, now what's going on?
The Monster Man moves in.
Come on, Box, nail him right here. Absolutely use the deep freeze on him early in the game. This guy definitely has an attitude. But whoa, what was that? He just nailed the Icebox in the back.
Monster
Where's
Man
the move book?
Will tell you that that is Bad Attitude's way of adjusting attitudes on the opposing team, which tonight is the T-Birds.
Led by the Icebox, known for the deep freeze, Billy Bob Bibas, Speedy Gonzalez, Dynamite Darryl, and of course, the living legend, Ralphie Valadares, right there, number 8 on your screen.
The whistle begins this second scoring cycle of 45 seconds. New Jenner for the T-Birds. Superman, Batman, and Captain America rolled into one. There he is. Stars and Stripes, Matt Bickham. Watch him go. Walking the rail and getting the full 6 points, while Dr. Fu ahead of him gets only two.
That's Stars and Stripes right there, Matt Bickham.
Who is now perhaps seeing stars. He is railed by Monster Man Bernie Jackson. So now Dr. Fu can score points by passing to T-Birds.
Ralphie.
He's going to ride Ralphie to the rail. T-Birds flying everywhere. The cycle ends, and this one was a good one for Dr.
Ralphie's
Fu.
Defense. Look at that.
The grand old man of the sport is down and shaken.
Don't call him an old man.
Yeah, you're right. You won't like that.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
The Monster Man punts the Icebox.
Get in the box.
Threw him in the penalty box.
I think he just did. I think what referee Don Astra just ordered Monster Man to the penalty pod right near us.
I don't even want to look at this lineup. It's disgusting.
Monster Man, Dr. Fu, it's a good team. And yes, standing right by this penalty pod is Monster Man for this cycle.
You're a little too close to our broadcast booth for me.
It's 14-6, T-Birds. The women will be skating the upcoming second period. There's Dr. Fu ahead of little Ralphie Valadares, who gets a whip from Dynamite up to that 14-foot high wall of death with this 80-degree pitch. 2 points for both Jenner on the wall and likewise two on the jump. And watch little Ralphie go. He uses all the track going inside and out. His players tie up the other black jerseys. He passes the ball, gets 3 points, and by tapping his helmet, stops the cycle before Dr. Fu can score any points for the other team.
Oh, come on. Pick on somebody your own size. That Monster Man, he is getting on my nerves. There, of course, is the Icebox coming to little Ralphie's defense.
Well, little Ralphie, David, said he would like the Icebox to drop from 357 pounds to 250, but at that moment, I think he was happy for every ounce on the guy.
Are you kidding? Bad chance. There's no way this guy's going to lose weight. Not on that diet of his. This guy has 4 or 5 T-bones. I think he has about 7 or 8 hamburgers a day, a gallon of ice cream. And if I kept going on and on and on, it'd be through this entire game. And besides all that, after all that, he has put down a couple of Alka-Seltzers.
Two new jitters for both teams, Billy Bob Bibas in the red, white, and blue, and Ninja Pete Christensen in the black. Billy Bob is tied up on the main course. He will not get to the jetway, so it's open to Ninja, who gets two on the wall, two on the jump. Billy Bob is still in trouble, so Ninja is going to have a good scoring cycle for Bad Attitude, which began the cycle trailing 19-10. Look at him pass the red, white, and blue. If he can get around Dynamite, he'll score still another individual point. Hell, and Monster Man drop kicks Dynamite over the rail. Ninja stops the cycle and has scored 8 unanswered points for Bad Attitude. It's a 1-point game.
Oh, come on, Monster Man. Where's the rule book? Look at that, Chuck. Now he's going after the Icebox again.
You must have kicked him, Jackson. Walk away from me when I'm talking
to you. He's not done yet, David. Look at him go.
Boom! Oh, come on. Dirty pool. This guy definitely has a major problem. After last week, the Icebox just came out last week and did a major number on the Monster Man. He just absolutely nailed him with that deep freeze play, and the Monster Man has gone berserk this week.
Meanwhile, Icebox, proud papa of two sons, rubbing his head but saying, I'm okay, keep me in, coach, keep me in. New Jetters, Charlie Saunders, a Bad Attitude, and Charlie has just broken the rules. He didn't do that preliminary lap around the main concourse. There he is, breakdancing after a fall. Meanwhile, Matt Bickham is doing it right. 6 points on the wall of death, and 6 points as well on the jump. Charlie Saunders cheated by going to the jetway too early, so it becomes a 0-point cycle for his Bad Attitude. And look at Stars and Stripes making hay, passing the black jerseys. He already has scored 13 points in this cycle, now 14. and he has a chance to still get more. 10 seconds left in the cycle. Can he get around Bernie Jackson, the Monster Man, for a final point? Monster Man riding him to the outside. There's Ralphie.
Oh, goal! Ralphie absolutely nailed the Monster Man with that flip there, making way for Stars and Stripes to score, and the Monster Man is humiliated once again by Ralphie. Ha ha, sweet revenge.
End of the period. Here's Shelley.
You're a bad attitude, Coach Georgia Haas. Word is you have a bombshell to drop.
You know, I am very pleased that Balladares has committed himself to this Hall of Fame because he will not be skating on the T-Birds. And those Tweety Bird twins, they will not be on the T-Birds also. One will be on the Maniacs and the other on the Validators. You got that, lady?
What do you
take it to the bank?
With Georgia Haas, soft spoken. Isn't she back to you, boys?
Well, what's that mean?
I can't believe it.
Guess we'll have to find out later. End of the first period. T-Birds lead Bad Attitude 35-18. Upcoming the women of this sport.
You can't split these two up.
They're the T-Bird twins. You will also hear from Wally George. Wally has a beat. Tonight's halftime headliner, Warren. As you look once more at the end of the first period, and Ralphie Balladares burying his wheels into the Monster Man.
That's it.
They'll match up again in the fourth period. We'll be back.
Don't go away. Roller Games will be right back.
Before the day I met you, life was so unkind. You're the key to my peace of mind. Was you
prepare thyself well, Dragon Warrior. Thy most challenging quest ever awaits. Go with speed, but go with patience. Seek out an arsenal, a dragon scale, a torch, and magic herbs. Use wisdom and cunning to choose thy commands, for the Dragon Lord is a fierce rival. Horrible and treacherous minions all guard the Evil One's island castle. Art thou ready, young one?
Yes, King Warrior.
And so begins a new epic, Dragon Warrior.
Nintendo, now you're playing with power.
Harry, if you don't want to end up in court,
you better send that child support.
I'm calling about your son, Grover. You better send money. His ski trip's over.
Send the money now, you dig. Or we won't make our next gig.
To send someone money fast, come to Western Union. We'll make sure it gets to any of our 13,000 locations, usually in 15 minutes or less.
Cruising.
Western Union, the fastest way to send money.
When you've got your power stroke going, you've got confidence that nothing's going to beat you. Introducing Power Stick, a new antiperspirant that gives you 24-hour odor and wetness protection in just one wide stroke. It takes two strokes of the leading stick to match Power Stick's one-stroke protection, 24-hour protection. In just one stroke, new Power Stick from Fabergé.
Here at Roller Sports Central. Well, friends, what we witnessed last week could signal the end of this great sport as we know it. One of America's great sports has turned into a zoo. In the final seconds of sudden death overtime, Skull and his biker buddy bandits, the Violators, beat the T-Birds. Joining us live is Skull. Now, Skull, all of America thinks you cheated, and so do I, you idiot. What do you say about that?
Look, old man, we beat the Thunder Chickens fair and square. They can't handle defeat from us. That's their problem. We got some surprises coming up for Ralphie and the T-Bird twins, and if they don't like it, they can eat it.
All right, you stupid nitwit. You are out of here. Now it's time for my roller beef. I want to get my hands on the guy who put a pit full of live alligators right on the Roller Games track. That really steams my windshield. What kind of moron would do something like that anyway? What are those mean green eating machines doing down there? Who put them there anyway?
Can you imagine the producers of Dynasty putting a crocodile in bed with Joan Collins? Think about that. This is supposed to be a sporting event. Good, clean, athletic, family fun. But no, someone, and I think I know who it is, would rather turn this into a Roman gladiator show with athletes facing death on camera. Well, I, for one, say enough is enough. Pull those gators off the track. Let them loose in the offices of the people responsible for turning this good sport into a three-ring circus. I'm calling for a special investigation to find out who is responsible. I'm Wally George, and that's tonight's Roller Beef, and I welcome your comments.
Roller Games Power Play of the Week is brought to you by Miles Laboratories. Earlier at the Super Rollerdome, the Rockers and the Violators fought it out in the big Commissioner's Cup Classic. Watch Dar the Star send sweet Stephanie sailing.
Clock counting down in this final cycle of the period. The men remember coming up next. Sweet Stephanie now without her helmet. Back in it, trying to pass Lady D and get points there. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, two, and ten.
Sweet Stephanie kisses the concrete at the hands of the queen of rock and roller games, Dar the Star. Now this.
You have heartburn with headache, right?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, that's great. I have the perfect remedy. It's fast and nothing's more effective.
Alka-Seltzer.
New advanced formula Alka-Seltzer.
Nah, I can't take Alka-Seltzer.
This one's easy to take. It has 75% less sodium, a fresh lemony taste, and you can take it with just a little water. How was it?
Great, but it's not Alka-Seltzer.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
It is.
No,
yes,
it is.
Don't
no,
you
it
feel
is.
Better?
Yes, but it's not Alka-Seltzer.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes,
new
it is.
Advanced formula.
It
believe it or not, it's Alka-Seltzer.
No, it isn't.
Roller Games Power Play of the Week has been brought to you by Miles Laboratories.
Now that summer is long gone, Alpine Light still brings you a light, refreshing taste of summer, even during the winter.
The obsession of a young man.
Is it okay if I call him?
I don't know. Do you want to?
Becomes a burning passion.
Paul, you're my student!
Have you been dating her?
That ignites the whole town.
We mean to preserve the morality here. You're in deep trouble.
Gerald Pendergast.
We have got a problem.
And Kate Jackson.
Damn it, I shouldn't have let it happen.
Two people treading on thin ice.
Watch the Channel 2 movie late night Saturday at 4 a.m.
Here and winter is on its way. To keep your family warm and full of energy, make sure you have plenty of Sunrise meats on hand. Sunrise meats, packed right here in Atlantic Canada for your assurance of freshness. This fall and winter, warm up to Sunrise meats. Always the perfect balance between quality, price, and taste.
Come on in your Canada.
David Sams, this is Chuck Underwood back in the Super Roller Dome where the T-Birds enjoy a comfortable lead of 35-18 on Bad Attitude. Here is how they score on the wall of death. If you get above that top line, you get 6 points. Above the lower line only, 2 points. Similar point totals on the jet jump, 2 if you simply keep your balance, 6 points if you clear that 12-foot distance line. Ladies up in the second period, and the Jetters will be Skinny Minnie Gwen Miller for the T-Birds and Hot Rod Margaret Christopher for Bad Attitude. There is Skinny Minnie, and watch her go. up to the walls, Lee Jetter. 2 points for her and two for Christopher. And now over the jump, and they both get two. And as they now go for individual points, David, your thoughts on Georgia Haas's bombshell?
Chuck, I'm at a loss for words. Georgia Haas may be right. She has found a rule in the back of the rule book, and I mean it is in the very back of the rule book, that an active skater can no longer skate if he is to go into the Hall of Fame.
The cycle ends. And it's a good one for Skinny Minnie, mugging before she is attacked by Georgia Haas. The T-Birds expand their lead to 40-22, as you now see Patsy Delgado pull the hair of electric Randy Whitman from behind. Two old rivals going at it.
So Georgia may force Ralphie to make a decision between skating or going into the Hall of Fame. And on the other note of contention, these two girls right here, the T-Bird twins, may in fact have to be split up, and that would be a devastating blow to this T-Bird team. Georgia claims that they were improperly drafted as one entity. Can you believe it? So, one of the T-Bird twins may have to go to the Violators and one to the Maniacs. And that would be, I just can't tell you, especially tonight of all times. Jennifer is getting married after tonight's game.
And Jennifer, Christine is the other T-Bird twin, is on the track right now. The new Jetters are Gina Go-Go Gonzalez in the red helmet, and there's the brat, Lyle Morse, great-great-granddaughter of Samuel Morse. Yes, the guy who invented the Morse code. Both ladies got 2 points on the wall, two on the jump, down goes Go-Go, and the brat is now going to try to score some individual points. Well, so the T-Bird team has to decide what life would be like not only without Ralphie Valadares, but also perhaps without the twins, which would reduce their female roster to only four skaters.
Chuck, I can't believe that the commissioner is going to go for that. I can't believe that the fans will live with that kind of a ruling. You just can't split up two twins that have been together their entire life.
Well, it is a day in the life in roller games as you look at the bad attitude lineup.
I don't even want to look at that lineup.
The Latin Spitfire is Patsy Delgado. You just saw the brat outscoring her T-Bird counterparts and pulling bad attitude back to within 14 points. Skinny Minnie is back jetting for the birds. Watch her go. She is a very adventurous skater. Up to the wall behind her is Hot Rod Christopher, and Hot Rod gets six. Only two on the wall for Skinny Minnie, and they both get two on the jump. Rod Christopher in the black is a former three-time world champion in BMX bicycle racing. But she right now is having a tough time because excellent rear blocking by that woman, Electric Randy Whitman, and in another venue on the court, excellent rear blocking by the Latin Spitfire, Patsy Delgado. There she goes. It is a very tough, brutal cycle for both jetters.
It's all out war out there.
5 seconds left in the cycle. 3 seconds, 2, 1, and it will end. But before being pummeled by those rear blockers, Hot Rod Christopher scored 8 points, and that woman, Skinny Minnie, only four. So bad attitude is coming back into this one.
And as we see on the LA Gear scoreboard, we're within a couple of minutes of that big halftime show. You asked for them, now they're back. Warrant returns with two big hits. Coming up in just a couple of minutes after this cat fight.
Now, speaking of big hits, Electric Randy and Hot Rod Christopher swinging away. And there is the venomous Georgia Haas.
Make her gator bait. I am so sick and tired of Georgia Haas stopping play. As you all know, each quarter is 6 minutes. You shut up, lady. I'm trying to get a couple of words in. Each quarter is 6 minutes in length. And normally, there is time for four or five scoring cycles within each six-minute quarter.
Well, in all likelihood, here comes the last one. And skating for the T-Birds will be Debbie McCorkle, the Corker. There she goes as the lead jetter. Behind her is the brat, Lyle Morris. 2 points per woman on the wall. And two on the jump. And how about Debbie McCorkle? She is living the fantasy. She says she was a T-Bird fan at age four. Ralphie Valadares was her idol. She is now skating as a T-Bird, and Ralphie is still around as both teammate and coach. But on this cycle, it is that woman, the brat, Lyle Morse, racking up points again. Morse is having a terrific game. Under 10 seconds left in the cycle. There goes McCorkle trying to pass another black jersey. It is Gail Bowers, the bopper, who just nudges her over the rail. Meanwhile, the Brat scores strongly. 9 points for the Brat in this cycle and her bad attitude. Only 4 for Demi McCorkle. And bad attitude at halftime has pulled to within just 5 points.
Unbelievable. I know what a block is.
That's Demi McCorkle on the left, Gail Bowers on the right, and poor Don Lastra, as always, in the middle. They're going to try and start another cycle. There are only 3 seconds remaining. Can they get back to the starting line? 2 seconds, one, no. Indeed, that will end the first half here in the Dome with the T-Birds leading bad attitude, 52-47.
Keep in mind, if this game ends in a tie, as it may, we could go to sudden death, and that's when we bring on the Gators. Returning in just a second. Love Date appears on the Super Rollerdome stage soon.
Before the day I met you, life was so unkind. You're the key to my peace of mind. Was you
love for your NES. Now you and the games are one. The Power Glove. Everything else is child's play.
This season, get all the big ones on one great album from Loverboy. Loverboy's big ones. They're too hot.
Winter in Maine, it can be beautiful. But before it looks like this, it looks like this. And if you're on the road, you need to be prepared. Make sure your car is in tip-top winter weather driving condition. Carry a flashlight, flares, chains, a bag of sand, a shovel, and blankets to help keep you warm if you get stranded. Drive slowly and be sure everyone is secured in car safety seats and seat belts. Maine winters are beautiful, but treacherous if you're not prepared. So plan ahead and think safety, because your family matters.
You buy Levi's non-zip, ever hip, button fly 501 jeans.
Welcome back to Halftime in the Super Roller Dome. What our next group loves about rock and roll is there are no rules. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Warrant.
Got a picture of your house, and you're standing by the door. It's black and white and faded. It's looking pretty worn. See the factory that it worked, silhouetted in the back. The memories are graver, man, they're really coming back. I don't need to be the king of the world, as long as I'm the hero of this night. You're in bed asleep.
Now wrap my arms around you so I can feel you breathe. I don't need to be a superman. As long as you will always be my biggest fan. Heaven isn't too far away. Along the boulevard, memories come rushing back and it makes it pretty hard. Well, I got nowhere left to go. No one really cares. I don't know what to do, but I'm never giving up on you. I'm
command return performance of Warrant. Next up, the ladies. It's a close game. Stay with us.
I've been lucky. I have two friends. There's something great about struggling.
Just a little bird, you know? Little ballerina. 5, 4, 1, 2.
I used to have dandruff, so I tried Head & Shoulders. Then I tried Selsun Blue. Blue is better.
Selsun Blue relieves dandruff flaking better than Head & Shoulders, and doctors recommend it more than Head & Shoulders, Denorex, and Tegrin.
Blue is better.
Selsun Blue.
Feeling good about yourself. Feeling carefree.
Carefree sugarless bubblegum. The full flavor's gonna blow you away. Now in wild cherry, too.
Let me tell you about my beer, Alpine Lager, one of Canada's first lager beers. Alpine is part of my family's long brewing tradition, a tradition that goes back to 1866, before Canada became a country. That's my great-grandfather, John James Dunold. You see, when it comes to brewing beer, I'm just a kid.
Smooth, clean Alpine, for people who know their lager. This one's ours.
Hi, my name is Eric Weinrich. As a hockey defenseman, my job is to help shut out the other team. But if drugs are a goal in your life, you could be shut out. Out of school, out of work, out of life. As a Maine kid who went from the Olympics to pro hockey, I can tell you that success comes from a little luck, a lot of hard work, and some good clean play. So keep a clear head, because playing with drugs is like skating on thin ice.
New Center 2 with Don Kerrigan, weeknights at 6.
Now for period 3 of this game between the T-Birds and Bad Attitude. T-Birds lead, but not by as many points as earlier on. The women had a very good second period for Bad Attitude. There goes Spicy Go-Go Gonzalez of the Bird, getting 6 points on the wall of death. No points, meanwhile, for Lyle Morse, the brat behind her. Both women get 2 on the jet jump. Now to pass those individual opponents as Marnie Smith, the tank, drops Go-Go. She'll now try to clear a path for Lyle Morse, and Morse gets around all 3 T-Birds, taps her helmet, and by doing so, ends the cycle. And little Lyle Morse has scored 26 points tonight. That is a season high in this league for both men and women.
Morse is an aggressive and a very effective jetter, but you know one thing? She has yet to make a 6-point play all season. Her point-scoring effectiveness on the jetway is unquestioned, but her ability to excel to that 6-point level remains a troubling question to this Bad Attitude team. We'll just have to see.
Bad Attitude's new jetter is the Latin Spitfire, Patsy Delgado. Debbie McCorkle is there in the red helmet. Randy Whitman is going to whip McCorkle. She'll be the lead jetter. 2 points for her on the wall, and likewise for Patsy Delgado, who is a veteran in this league and has shrugged off fractured ribs and a broken tailbone, and she has accumulated those injuries by playing it just that rough. McCorkle will re-enter the track. The T-Bird twins are in, and down goes one of them. And now Delgado rolls electric Randy, and the Latin Spitfire is throwing flames in his cycle, doing an excellent job. Can she get around Skinny Minnie? Gwen Miller with just seconds remaining in the cycle.
Yes! Oh, what a hit!
Skinny Minnie folds over the rail, and Delgado has done well for the Bad Attitude. But still, they trail in a big way. 74-60. Delgado and her team is down by 14. And there is Georgia Hotz spewing vinegar on Don Lastra, as she has done for years in this sport. Not only a bad attitude, but clearly a different attitude.
Come on, make up gator bait.
Well, she says she will be forever scarred by the nickname her father gave her when she was just a child. Her dad called her sweetheart.
This woman once again being humiliated in front of a worldwide audience of millions for the second week in a row.
There's Patsy Delgado. She has been ordered into the infield, I think. And she is going to ignore the penalty. She apparently somehow got out of it. She's skating. There goes Debbie McCorkle again, and behind her is the bopper, Gail Bowers. McCorkle, 2 points on the wall. Likewise for Gail Bowers. And although shaky over the jump, they also get two on it. McCorkle trying now to get around Patsy Delgado. Can she do it? Not at the moment. Gail Bowers trying to pass red, white, and blue. Big tie-up. T-Bird tying up everybody there. The jetpacks are frozen. Meanwhile, Delgado is fighting against Debbie McCorkle. Here comes Skinny Minnie into the pile.
Making way for McCorkle to score.
McCorkle sneaks by in the last second and gets 3 points.
That's a great defensive play there. Let's take another look at it. A Skinny Minnie just knocks down this team right here.
This is 10 pins, and that's only 105 pounds of Skinny Minnie. Damn. As she drops all three black jerseys to the Masonite.
Now keep an eye right there on Debbie McCorkle as she passes that entire bad attitude team and racks up major points.
Now for what could be the final cycle of the third period. As you see the spread, T-Birds leading and comfortably so. Skinny Minnie Miller is going to jet for the T-Birds, and the Latin Spitfire remains the jetter for bad attitude. 45-second scoring cycle. There's a double whip for Skinny Minnie. It's called an atomic whip. Can she get 6 points?
Oh,
yes!
There she is, Skinny Minnie. Probably the most underrated player in all the league.
And she got six on the jump, and Delgado is struggling, and look at Skinny Minnie go. Around Gail Bowers, around Marnie Smith. Now trying to pass the brat, and she does so. Only 2 points thus far in this cycle for Delgado in bad attitude, and there they are locked in Mortal Kombat. Who's going to win this one?
Delgado deserves that one.
Sweet revenge for Skinny Minnie, who was sent over the rail by that lady one cycle ago.
Now a jolly wow, come on! I can't believe this. Throw that woman in the alligator pit. Obviously, Chuck, she's so humiliated by this score that okay. Now she's taking out her frustration on probably the smallest woman in all the league.
Skinny Minnie has just scored 18 points in the cycle. Down goes Georgia. Down goes Delgado. End of the period. And here is Shelly Jameson in the infield.
I'm gonna have to do it because it's getting out of hand out here.
The Monster Man is nasty. Here he comes.
Wait a minute. Who cares about a deep freeze? I haven't seen it yet. Are you scared? Why you don't do it? I haven't seen it all, period. You scared to do it?
Are we gonna see it?
I'm gonna have to do it later on because this man is getting out of hand. I'm gonna do it on the.
I look scared.
Do it now. You're scared.
Stand by for the deep freeze. It's gonna be ugly.
The fourth period is coming up. It could be devastating when the icebox attempts to chill out the Monster Man.
Sunrise prepared meats.
It's a good, 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 good morning. It's a good, 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 good day.
When you shop for your family's good meals, look for the sunrise and follow it to great taste and nutrition. Sunrise carefully selects and prepares only fine meats for quality, flavor, and value.
It's a good, 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 good morning. It's a good, 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 good day.
The Vernier Super Drugstores have a special way to remember special people during the holidays. An ambassador card has just the right message for each of them. To a loving mother, a wonderful father, a hard-working husband, or a much-loved daughter. Buy three cards, get the fourth card of equal or lesser value free. Make this a Christmas to remember at LaVertier's Super Drug Stores. LaVertier's Super Drug Stores, for cards and all of your holiday needs. The secret world is like nothing you've ever seen.
A startling journey to the known and the unknown.
The natural and the supernatural.
A world of werewolves
and vampire bats.
Black magic and white sharks.
Devilish demons and mystical mountains.
Where magic and legend are a way of life.
Come with us now to a place where civilization itself is no more than a myth.
Christopher Lee holds your passport to the hidden world of living magic. The secret world.
Watch Secret World late night Saturdays at 3 a.m. only on Channel 2.
Most Canadians are hardworking,
are you ready, Steve?
Mild-mannered people who enjoy quiet, intellectual activities. And the clean, cold taste of a genuine Canadian beer. Molson Canadian. What beer's all about.
How you celebrate a Jeopardy says a lot about you. There's the smash-up.
What is a straight flush?
Yes!
The high five with belly rub.
Who was Pavlova?
The spike-up.
Who was Beethoven?
The Twickenham School's polite hand-clapping. And, of course, the revelry reflex. Jeopardy, the most fun you can have with your brain.
Jeopardy weeknights at 7:30 here on Channel 2.
Number four for the T-Birds is possible Rookie of the Year, Stars and Stripes Matt Bick.
One of the greatest challenges I've ever had to come across has been skating the Wall of Death. It has taken great persistence and hard training. It's been very brutal to skate the Wall of Death. I have done it, and if it wasn't for my coach, Ralph Valadares, I couldn't have done it.
Matt Bickham will indeed be jetting as we begin this fourth period of play with his T-Birds enjoying a comfortable lead on Bad Attitude.
Matt Bickham, Stars and Stripes. He stands for everything that is right. Truth, justice, and the American way. This guy's got spirit, desire. Chuck, you know, he's a thinking skater. He's got unlimited power potential. He may not be the biggest man out there, but he's definitely one of the smartest.
Well, he got six on the wall. Charlie Saunders ahead of him only got two. And he also got six on the jump, and Saunders only two. So Stars and Stripes is widening the lead for his T-Birds. Can he now get around Monster Man as Charlie Saunders spins out?
The great thing about Stars and Stripes, he actually brings 25 kids to every game and pays for their seats.
Well, right now, Matt Bickham is paying a price, as is Charlie Saunders, because the rear blockers are doing an excellent job as the cycle ends.
No doubt about it, she definitely hates TV cameras, and she hates these T-Birds. Once again, she's going down in a major defeat. And oh, come on! I am so sick and tired of seeing that out there tonight. Throw that man in the penalty pot. Give the icebox a break. The man's just trying to do his job.
108 to 70, and although the icebox individually has had better moments, his team is delighting in this enormous lead, clearly coming back from that upset loss last week in sudden death overtime.
Oh, and he looks hurt. He definitely looks hurt.
The box will take a breather. New Jetters, Speedy Gonzalez for the T-Birds and the Bulldog right there in the black helmet, Scott Casco. First up to the Wall of Death will be Speedy. He one-legs it, but gets only 2 points. He's frustrated. Also two on the jump. Waiting for him is the Monster Man.
Boom!
A bit groggy. He'll try again. Oh, same result. Meanwhile, the Bulldog goes racing by. He's getting individual points. He's going to coattail behind the Monster Man. Around Ralphie Valadares. Around Billy Bob Bibas. Around Dynamite Darrell. Look out!
Oh, come on!
A body slam by the Monster Man. Now, you see the Bulldog celebrating, but we're looking at the scoring table and learning that Scott Casco will get no points for his bad attitude on this cycle. Reason? He did not lap the opposing players at the start of the cycle. He is only now realizing that.
Ooh, there she is, Chuck. Renee, my favorite cheerleader. And there. T-Bird fans all the way. They love their T-Birds.
Well, and they also seem to be adapting to this sport with this new serpentine figure eight concourse and all that it provides, this evolution of what used to be the old roller derby on a simple banked oval. And there's the guy who knows both tracks well. Ralphie Valadares trailing the Monster Man up the wall. The law of gravity works on the Monster Man. He gets only two on the jump, so does Ralphie. Two on the wall before that, and now they try to pass individuals. They both do, so they both get three quick points.
Oh, this is a matchup.
Ralphie's almost drafting the big guy behind him. A forearm by Ralphie.
Oh, can you believe it? Ralphie knocked Monster Man up to the pile, and now Ralphie will get all the points.
The Monster Man gets none because instead of passing the pile, he crashed into the rear of it. And here he comes, circling, moving in on little Ralphie.
Come on, pick on somebody your own size.
Like, wait a minute, what's the box?
He wouldn't dare. The Great Ice Box right there with little Ralphie Valadares. I'll tell you, this T-Bird team, superstars all the way. There is not one weak link on this team, Chuck.
We are under 30 seconds. That means this will be the final cycle of the game. The T-Birds are going to win. They are enjoying an enormous lead on Bad Attitude. And there is their Jetter, little big man, Dynamite Darryl. Only 5-4 behind him, Dr. Fu. 2 points for each man on the wall. Ditto on the jump. And in these final seconds, David, T-Bird fans must be wondering, will Ralphie choose to skate or enter the Hall of Fame?
That's a tough one. Little Ralphie Valadares deserves to be in the Hall of Fame.
There he is.
For as long as he's been skating, nearly five decades now, I can't believe that he would want to hang up his skates. And I can't believe that Georgia Haas is the culprit behind this whole mess.
Final seconds of the game, which the T-Birds will win. Dr. Fu is face down on the concrete, and it is over. The T-Birds have defeated Bad Attitude 135-87, and a disappointed and dejected Georgia Haas looks on with her Monster Man. They have covered Bad Attitude in the Super Rollerdome, and their fans like it. And we'll be back.
You're watching the War Network.
Yeah, I don't know where it comes from, you know. As long as it keeps coming, right? How old are you?
15.
Yeah. 501.
What's wrong, Doug?
Mr. Kayam, I hate shaving.
You're using the wrong equipment. Try this Remington microscreen. The microscreen shaves as close as a blade or your money back. It has two thin, flexible screens. The first shaves incredibly close. The second even closer.
Smooth. Now I know why you bought the company.
The Remington microscreen shaves as close as a blade or your money back. No other shaver makes that promise. Now, buy this Remington and get a hygienic clipper free.
My first dance. And who danced with me except Jeffrey Kaiser, the biggest nerd? Cheer up. You're drinking milk, and this is you in a few years. Not with this brazed face and gross hair. Well, you're growing fast, and milk can help you get a great smile and gorgeous hair. But my body, the only difference between me and the guys is this dress.
Hey, you can see we turned out just fine.
Who is that?
That's Jeffrey Kaiser. Milk. It does a body good.
You need a tattoo shop.
Tetris.
Have you been tetrisized?
Square, rectangle, trapezoid, tetrazoid.
Nintendo introduces Tetris.
Put a piece here.
Put a piece there.
Use your thumbs.
Use your eyes.
Find yourself Tetris-sized.
Now you're playing with power.
show tonight before a full house and a noisy one here in the Dome. The T-Birds win big over Bad Attitude, but Georgia Haas has challenged Ralphie Valadares, saying that he can skate or he can enter the Hall of Fame, but not both. She is also trying to split up the T-Bird twins. David Sams has more on that. David?
The record book may show sweet victory, but the fact is it may be an indirect defeat. Ralphie, are you going to hang up the skates or go into the Hall of Fame?
David, I don't know at this moment. I don't know what's really going on. This Georgia Haas been giving nothing but trouble. I'm going to have to talk to Mr. Griffith and find out exactly what we can do, because at this moment, I don't know. I'm just so upset about the Georgia that it's really got me puzzled.
I think all America shares your concerns, and believe me, not only that.
Listen,
but
I am sick and tired of you Tweety Birds and your song and dance. You're going to the Violators, you're going to the Maniacs, and you has been, old man. Forget it, you'll never skate again, you understand?
We will keep you posted on this controversy. Back to Chuck.
All right, David, the T-Birds have won. Next week, it'll be this same Bad Attitude against Hot Flash. Please join us then.
The following companies have paid a fee for promotional consideration. Gaetano invites your family to get to know the Gaetano family of products. Gaetano Bodywear, the spirit of family.
Hero, cologne for men from Prince Machiavelli.
It's Electronic Battleship, where you program an all-out attack to sink your enemy's fleet.
You sank my battleship.
Battleship and Electronic Battleship from Milton Bradley.
Balance of power and an easy alliance of faith. When I'll be other and one I'm still on the rails.
Step through this door and you can be a legend. Welcome to Legends Restaurant and Sports Bar, where good friends, good times, and great food come together.